Is it healthy to eat meat and nothing else? Well, in today's video, we're going to be looking at the carnivore diet, answering three key questions. What do you eat on the carnivore diet? What are the potential benefits of the carnivore diet? And what are the downsides of a carnivore diet? So that by the end of this video, you'll know whether or not you should try eating nothing but meat. G'day there, I'm Jesse Crow, the traveling scientist, and after spending years studying pharmacology, I'm here to help you live smarter, happier, and healthier lives. Now, if you have any questions or thoughts about the carnivore diet, let us know right now in the comment section down below, because I find this topic super fascinating and I want to discuss it further with you. So, what is the carnivore diet? Well, a carnivore diet involves eating only animal products. It's like the opposite of a vegan diet. Beef, chicken, pork, lamb, fish, eggs, milk, and cheese. And some of the hardcore carnivores won't even touch the last few. Only meat.
Steak and eggs and steak. That's what you should have for breakfast. Delicious.
That means that a carnivore diet involves cutting out everything else. No fruits, no vegetables, no pasta or rice or bread or legumes or nuts or seeds, no cake, no chocolate, no sugar, no carbs, no nothing.
None of that. Or any of the others.
Not even alcohol or coffee. Seriously? No alcohol? Jesus Christ. So, what are the benefits of being on the carnivore diet? Well, one of the main potential benefits is weight loss, and it's well known that high protein and low carbohydrate diets often promote weight loss in a number of different ways. First, protein makes you feel more full, which is going to cause you to eat less. Second, protein increases your metabolic rate, which is going to cause your body to burn more calories. Third, this diet prevents you from eating junk food and drinking alcohol, which is obviously going to help anybody lose weight. The carnivore diet is also believed to help individuals with certain diseases such as arthritis, psoriasis, and even depression. Studies have shown that... Wait, really? There are no studies into the carnivore diet. Wow. I didn't even expect that. Apparently, there have been no research studies into the short-term or long-term effects of eating a carnivorous diet. We can only take examples from history, like Inuit tribes that seem to live a healthy life, eating nothing but seal and whale meat. And that's because they didn't really have many food options. So what are the downsides of being on a carnivore diet? Well, one is having an increased risk of several diseases. A diet of just meat is extremely high in cholesterol and saturated fats, which is likely going to increase your risk of heart disease. Furthermore, processed meats like sausages and bacon have been proven to increase your risk of colorectal cancers. And many meats are also high in sodium, which is going to increase your blood pressure and increase your risk of suffering from kidney and liver diseases. Another issue with the carnivore diet is a lack of essential vitamins and minerals. Believe it or not, fruits and vegetables actually contain some pretty important nutrients that our bodies need to survive. Fiber, for example. Animal products don't contain any fiber, and if you don't consume fiber, you're gonna get really constipated. Also, vitamin C. Animal products contain very little vitamin C, and it gets broken down when the meat is cooked. So, if you don't get any vitamin C, you're going to turn into a pirate and get scurvy.
Fuck.
Finally, the carnivore diet just isn't sustainable, and I mean that in two different ways. First, it's expensive. Do you know how much it costs to eat meat for every single meal? It's a lot! And second, farming animals for meat is incredibly intensive and really bad for the environment. And I don't want to get into too much detail here, but to put it simply, with the current global climate and the growing population, it's just not feasible for everybody to eat meat for every meal. It just doesn't make sense. We can't do it. So in conclusion, the carnivore diet involves eating animal products and cutting out everything else. That means no sugar, no junk food, no alcohol, and that's really good. But it also means no fruits, no vegetables, and no whole grains. That's not so good. This diet can help you to lose weight, which is awesome. And many people have claimed that it can help with various diseases that are otherwise untreatable. But there's no scientific research proving the benefits of the carnivore diet, or the downsides of a carnivore diet either. Those studies just haven't been done yet. So if you want to try an all-meat diet, go for it. Just be aware that you may be putting your body at serious risk, and you should really talk with your doctor before trying the carnivore diet. Personally, I believe that all of the benefits that come from the carnivore diet come simply from cutting out all of the unhealthy foods, and that you could achieve all of those benefits and more by having simply a well-rounded, balanced diet. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button down below. And let me know how you feel about the carnivore diet, or if you have any questions, I'd love to answer them. Just chuck them in the comment section down below. Finally, next week's video is going to be all about intermittent fasting and how it can improve your diet. So make sure you subscribe for more traveling science every single week. And I'll see you guys next Science Sunday. Cheers. Hate it. And your risk of you know how much it costs? There's no studies. Craig, are you sure about that? Did you do your research, Craig? Is this right, Craig? Craig, seriously? Did you do your research?